Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ronnie Marmo, and I'm the very proud artistic director of Theater 68, and I hope everyone is staying safe during this crazy time. I want to welcome you to our annual one-act festival, and this year, we're presenting this festival as a fundraiser trying to keep the doors open at Theater 68 on both coasts. As in years past, each one-act has been written, directed, and will be performed by members of the company. We realize this is a very unique experience, and since we can't invite you to our theater, we thought we'd bring our show to you, our virtual stage, as it were. We've learned a lot in this process. Zoom is essentially a hybrid between theater and film. And although it's not exactly the same as us being together in the same room, we've embraced the medium and we're excited to present these plays to you. We also understand Zoom fatigue is a very real thing. So what we've decided to do is present one 10-minute play each evening. Essentially, each play will run once a week for 6 weeks. There will also be a brief Q&A after the show, so please stick around for that. Now, finally, we've decided not to charge for tickets. Instead, we're asking for your donation by going to Venmo and typing in Theater 68, or go to your browser, type in paypal.me/theater68. In both cases, theater is spelled with an R-E. There's no amount too small. So sit back from the orchestra of your own home. The shows are brief, they're light, they're easy to get to, and we really, really appreciate your support. So from the bottom of our hearts, thank you, enjoy the show, and onward we go.
Mom.
Hello.
Mom? Mother?
I can hear you.
I can hear you.
Can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
Sweetie?
One sec, Mom. One sec. Hey, Mom, can you hear me?
Yes. Honey, hi.
Hey, Mom.
How are you, sweetie? What, you don't have time for your mother anymore, Mr. Busy Pants?
I have time for you, Ma, but yeah, if you must know, I have been a Mr. Busy Pants. I've just been looking for work nonstop. It's crazy. Look, I'm sorry. I'll try and call more.
That's all right. Don't worry about it. Listen, have you been getting out at all? You know, flying, getting some fresh air?
You know I can't fly right now. The bats are not particularly well-loved, given the,
I know. Well, go for a walk. You look pale.
Okay, Ma, you can't see me, first of all. How do you know?
Are you eating healthy? You know, I read on the Facebook that a vampire ate just one human and spread COVID to 45 other vampires. Oy. Listen, I know we can only have those man-made blood snacks right now, so you're not forgetting to eat, are you?
No, Ma, I am not forgetting to eat. Money is a little tight.
Do you need to send you some money?
No.
I'll send you over PayPal.
Ma, no, I'm eating. I'm fine. Everything is fine.
Yeah. But if you need anything, you call your mother. And remember, no humans right now.
Okay, Ma. No humans. How is everything going at the castle?
I got book club. We're reading Midnight Sun. It's about that shiny vampire boy. You know, I think he's Jewish. Anyway, I gotta run. Call your mother. I love you. Kisses. Ma, ma, ma.
Ma, ma, ma. There goes dinner. Pizza. Delivery guy.
Oh, phone's ringing off the hook around here. Hey, one guy, pizza, fastest pizza. to delivery in the West past 25 years. What can I get for you?
Hi. Yeah. Quick question, good sir. Do your delivery drivers get tested for COVID?
Sure do. Sure do. Yeah.
Oh, that is awesome, man. I think I will have a plain large plain large pie.
Is that all?
Yes.
No garlic dipping sauce with that?
No. I am allergic.
Oh, hey, something's burning back there. Hey, okay, that's one large pie. That'll be $12.50. My guy will have a machine be there in 2 minutes.
Thank you.
2 minutes. Okay. Oh, man.
Everywhere.
Hey, you Alex Tepish?
Come on. Yeah, man. Have you made other deliveries today?
Why? Yeah, of course. Sure. Why?
Without a mask, genius?
Hey, I was tested 2 weeks ago. Hey, you still want your pie?
No, go away.
Oh, God, I think I ruptured something. Oh.
Yo, Alex, it's Jer. We still hanging tonight. Hey, Jerry. I totally forgot. Yeah. Man, come on over. Way ahead of you already here. Really?
What's up? I brought you some dangness, bitch.
Oh, thank you. Come on in. Have a seat.
Nice place.
Thank you.
Bruh, you do look pale. Your mom was right.
Bro, wait. Hold on 1 second. How do you know what my mom said?
Come on, man. You know. Me and your mom, we be texting back and forth. But that's not the point. You'll never guess what happened, man.
What happened, Jer?
Okay, look. So, I was sitting at home, right? And yeah. I get this text message. And it's from Amber. What?
What? No way, man.
Wait. So, I said to her, right? I said, look.
So sweet.
I know, dude. It was so sweet. You should have been there, man.
Wait, hold on 1 second. You went to a party, dude?
Yeah, dude. The other day at Sean's place. I'm telling you.
The other day? You went recently, Jerry.
Yeah. Just yesterday.
Did you social distance at this party with
40 to 50 people?
40 to 50 people?
I mean, yeah, you know, except for like when we did shots and we played video games. But other than that, yeah, definitely. Whew.
Look at the time, man. Wow.
Yeah, look at the time. It's like 6 minutes past 4:20. I got a blunt in the car. I should be going. You have a good one.
You too, man. What did you forget, Jerry?
Hey, is this Unit 5?
Yeah.
Could you sign this for me, please?
Sure. How you doing?
Hey,
is this true? Do you really follow all the CDC guidelines?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, safety is awesome.
Safety is awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. Dude, I am so sorry. Oh no. Oh. Oh no. No, COVID. Cider. Cider. Wait. What is that? I didn't even order that.
Dear Alex, I know it's been tough to get any good meals right now, and I know you said you're doing fine, but Mother's worried.
Have you seen my iPad?
No? Did you leave it in the bathroom?
The bathroom? Why would it be in the bathroom? I haven't been to the bathroom.
Just a little surprise.
Something. I found it.
Where was it?
It was in the bathroom.
Your father's gonna be the second death of me. I love you. Oh, your mother.
Hey. Hey, Mom. Can you hear me? Mom. Yeah. Keep bleeding, keep bleeding love. You cut me open.
Trying hard not to hear, but they talk so loud. Their piercing sounds fill my ears.
Hi, Joe Montaigne here, wanting to thank you for your donation, which will help Theater 68 continue to be one of our finest local theaters here in the United States. Thanks again.
All right.
Hey everyone, thanks for coming. Congratulations to the cast. I'm Annie Lanzalotto of the New York Company at Theater 68. Congratulations, closing night for Hunger Pains. Yeah. Written by Yasha Rayzberg, directed by Vikram Bhoyrul, starring Jay McCain, Stacy Ray Toyon, Malik Bailey, and Dave Faulkner. All right. A lot of questions in the chat for you all. And, you know, this is like the cast party. So let's do some crosstalk. You know, let me hear you guys asking each other questions. The first question goes out to Dave. How do you have so much energy? You know, how do you put that zip into your step? What do you, can you teach us how to do that?
Oh yeah, yeah. Mission Impossible theme.
Yep.
That's it, man. You know, that's the key. Bum, 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 da, 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 da. Do that, man. You got energy for days.
Hey. Do you listen to that, Dave? That's your pre-show jam? Is that what the deal is?
Right before I go on, you know, I'm just getting in that Mission Impossible mood.
And what about in life? Do you do that in life too? You have the same man, zip?
Music for everything.
All right.
Music is without music's everything. It's the battery for my whole life.
All right. Okay, next question from Abdullah. This goes for, I guess, Yasha and Vikram. Have you discussed future adaptations for this piece in theater or film?
No, would be the short answer. we haven't discussed it. I've thought about it, certainly. You know, I'd love to see this go up on a stage, or even as a you know, a short film, or even a slightly longer film, if, you know, things were added to the script. But I love these characters, and I think they're fun, and I think the premise is one that can be expanded. Some things had to even be cut down from the original script for Zoom, right? Like, you know, and that's certainly not a criticism. In fact, I'm amazed the way that they managed to get all those like cool effects and sounds. And the thing they added tonight with the bottle, I mean, that was so cool. And so, you know, it was just like, it was very, yeah, so they did it beautifully. But I'd love to see what more can be done with this piece, you know?
Is your mind turning, Yasha? You know, developing scenes and...
Yes, I have some new ideas. I have some sort of fresh takes, things I'd change, things I'd take from what Vikram did and put them into my sort of original thought, you know, and mix that all together, right? It's there's a lot here, and I think you know, I have a new perspective on it than I did when I wrote it, certainly, and I'm excited to see what comes of it in the future.
All right, Vikram, anything to add about that?
No, absolutely. Look, this is a really cool piece. I think one of my favorite parts of these one acts is every time you see a piece go up, especially one that you've written, one that you worked on quite a bit, is that you get inspired to do more with it. You see it up and you see it all come together, and then you're like, oh wow, I could do more with this, or I could change this, or you know, this is working so well and it's just like how I envisioned. And so for me, I always feel like the one act is like the very beginning of like the creation of like that final story that you want, because it just inspires you so much when you see these actors bring it to life, you know. So I'm sure Yasha is feeling just as inspired as I have been when I see these one acts to, you know, wrestle with these stories and see what's really fun to work with. But absolutely, that's no exception.
All right. Courtney wants to know from the actors, how are you similar to your characters and how are you different than your characters?
I am in real life, a mother of three, and I'm similar in terms of you definitely forever worry about your chicks. And I do love it when they're all home and in the nest. I hope I'm not quite as on top of and overbearing as this particular mother, but she means well.
I would have to say that in real life, you know, unfortunately, I have been friends with a few bloodsuckers. They haven't been as nice as Alex, you know, but, you know, that happens. Also, I would definitely say from time to time, you know, I can definitely be as high spirited as Jerry is.
Take it.
I'm definitely hungry. I get hungry. I kind of get a little cranky sometimes. I lose my temper maybe a little bit. Bike delivery driver's next, I think. A lot of similarities.
And Dave, Mr. One Guy Pizza over there, what about you?
I'm always enthusiastic. You know, always, giving 110% in places where, you know, probably doesn't need to be 110%, but doing it anyway, you know, just like, you know, yeah, let's do it. Let's go.
Did the one guy pizza come up in the rehearsal process, or where'd that come from?
I don't know. I forget. I made it up. We were talking about something. I can't remember. Vikram and I were going back and forth on what to call the pizza thing. Cause the pizza guy was kind of different when we first started, and it kind of evolved a little bit. And I don't know. I just came up with, you always see like the five guys or the, you know, the two guys from Italy or the, you know, just one guy pizza, you know? So that just popped in the old head.
He does it all. He answers the phone. He runs out and delivers. He does it all. Okay.
That's it.
Courtney wants to know for everybody, what part of your artistry grew the most during this whole Zoom run? It's a good question. Did you hear the question, Yasha? All right. All right, somebody take the ball on that one.
Well, there's a whole big learning curve on Zoom and the hybrid that it is. And there are parts of it that I really like and parts of it that I don't. it's a little constraining in some ways, but the constraints tend to force creativity. You have to figure it out when you're constrained to this. So that creativity has been really great. I miss the smell of the theater and being with live people very much. So I think I've grown because I'm being forced to get used to the new technology. But yeah, that's it.
For me, it's I listen better. On Zoom, you have to listen more. There's so few visual clues. You know, you can't really pick up on those visual cues or feeling your act, you know, feeling something in the moment. Often when you're on with a person, you can, you know, you use a lot of your other senses. But when on Zoom, you've got to listen to your other actor. Because that's really only, because, you know, we can't even really look at them sometimes. You got to do that Zoom look thing. So all you really have to interact with them is the listening. And so I think I've become a better listener.
I think I was reminded that, like, we often have way less excuses than we think when it comes to making content. You know, that if we were able with the production value and with all the constraints and stuff that we had to put this together and to make these really fun stories, not just tonight, but throughout this whole week, what the theater is doing. I think it was just another reminder that, like, you know, if you have the time and if you're fortunate enough to have the time and the strength to act and perform, go do it, you know, because you can find the means of creating art and really putting stuff out there. And, you know, it was just, I think the last, I guess, like few months, the last like 2 months, especially of theater and largely due to these 1X, have been like getting a lot of us back into the routine of acting consistently and of working and rehearsing at the level that we usually do at this time of year. So I think that's what this has really proven to me, that it doesn't matter if there's a global pandemic, that, you know, you can find the means to put art out there and do it well.
Bravo, bravo.
I think for me, you know, it's just a reminder to just to have fun. You know, sometimes you get roles and you kind of get bogged down and, you know, the thought process, the characters, you know, and everything that goes into it. And you forget to, you know, have fun and really, you know, take pride in the process and really explore different options and different avenues with the character. So definitely I feel like every performance that I've brought has been, you know, a different variation of this character and, you know, still finding different levels and different things to play with. So, you know, just, it's good to be able to still have fun with this.
I found that it was really cool to have a piece that I wrote and then have to give it away. And I, you know, I spoke about this a little before, but it was like giving away a baby, you know, like I created this piece. I had ideas. I had, you know, I knew exactly what I wanted to see. Right. And then I had to give it away to someone else. And that there, you know, there was a chance that I was going to be very displeased and I wasn't, and that's awesome. And that makes me so much more comfortable in the future to give my piece away, right, to directors like Vikram or these actors, right. And allow them to let their creativity and their ingenuity mesh with mine, and develop this, you know, what they put up. All right. And I mean, that's incredible. And I feel inspired now, as I said before, and I feel encouraged that this is something I could do in the future. Again, you know, I could write something and pass it off and let someone else take that vision and create, you know, and I love that. I love that.
Jay, did you want to answer this question?
Which question?
About you know, growth.
Didn't I just answer that?
Yeah, I think Dave answered this. I think Jay.
I was saying Jay.
When it comes to like Zoom, sometimes you have to like put a little bit more of yourself, I think, to translate through. And so with that comes like what Dave was saying, just maybe like becoming a better listener. And then also there's like a different place and space you can play in. It's fun. It's fun.
All right. We have a follow-up question for Yasha from Eli and Emily. Yasha, where did you get your inspiration for this play?
The inspiration came from a couple different sources. Buffy the Vampire Slayer is probably the biggest, with the vampire idea. When we got the theme, of this festival, primal instincts, I was trying to think of like what could be done with that, right? You know, certainly there's sexuality, there's, you know, a violence sort of animalistic, but I looked up the term and I found the primal instinct of a mother's love for her child. And to me, that sort of hit like, wow, that's not something, you know, that's not the first thing you think of when you think of primal instincts, right? And I loved that. And so, you know, I took this idea of vampires and I took the idea of this mother's love for a child. And then I took COVID and I thought, all right, let's make it make sense now. I just started thinking up vampire puns that fit COVID, you know, like the bat or the garlic dipping sauce, you know, it just rolled around that. It just snowballed into these characters, you know, of this mother who's a little overbearing, certainly, but as Stacy said, has a good heart and really just wants to see her son do well. And of this son who's struggling a little bit and needs a mother's love, but isn't taking it. And so it's, you know, I just rolled from there. And that was that. Yeah. And the mother, you know, obviously I have a Jewish mother of my own. So it was, you know, she was certainly a fun character to write.
All right. About Theater 68, we are accepting donations at Venmo at Theater 68 and at PayPal at Theater 68. paypal.me/theater68. And everyone, you know, could tell you how much this community sustains us, especially in 2020. And, you know, everyone feel free to talk about that while we're together the next 10 minutes or so. So Vikram, here's a question for you.
Sure.
Psychology of directing. Can you talk about how do you keep a cast loose and inspired?
Well, these guys are stiff as boards. You know, it's so hard to get them to just give me anything. But no, I'm kidding. I'm kidding. It's the easiest thing in the world working with these guys. I keep everything really honest and transparent with my thought process with all these characters. I like to have a conversation with all the actors about their characters' want, the obstacles the characters are facing, and just kind of how to build up like those fun traits. And I love that part of the collaboration with the actors. I always like to say I don't have the right questions, but I don't have the right answers, but I do have the right questions. And so, you know, when I'm working with people, I know what to poke, and these guys were so good at letting me just experiment, you know? And so I think these guys trusting me and me trusting them just kept everything so easy this entire way through. Even when we ran into spots, we were like, how do we fix this out? There's nothing that was ever stressful, you know? So by having a very good cast, it's easy to work with. That's how I made this go well.
And talk a little about, you know, sheltering in place and Theater 68. And being able to put on this production the past, you know, several weeks of rehearsal, then 5 weeks of a show. So really, yeah. It's 2 months of being together.
Yeah, it's great. These are like, you would think that we'd hit like Zoom fatigue or kind of like a Zoom plateau where at a certain point we're just like, I don't know how much more we can do. But every time we rehearsed, every time we met, we found something new to work with. We were all very aware of what improvements we need to make from our last rehearsal or our last performance and stuff like that. And so I think because we were all, we never just accepted that, hey, you know what, it's Zoom, it's going to be as good as it can be. Because we all wanted this to be as good as it could possibly be, it kept each week exciting. It kept us motivated and give us that same kind of energy or a similar kind of energy to what it's like doing it at theater and stuff like that. I gotta say, tech rehearsal when you can do it in your sweatpants and not have to drive to the theater and get a foot massage, eat some pasta and stuff like that, all that stuff that I was doing. That part is a lot easier. You know, the comfort part of Zoom, I'm going to miss that a lot when the world opens. But aside from that, you know, we made it work.
Yeah, and the commute is amazing.
Oh, it's great. I was still late a couple times, but the commute is great.
There's a question from Elle. What was your favorite line tonight or any other night in what some other character said?
Oh, I got it. It's got to be, you know, I brought you some bangers, bitch. What is it you're saying? Hold the box up again.
I brought you some dankness, bitch.
Oh, dang. I can never really hear it, but I love the line anyway. I thought at first it was like those little things from New Orleans, you know, the little things with the B that...
Well, this is, you know, whatever you thought it was, that's what it was. That's art. You interpret it.
When you deliver that line, that's always, that's, I love it.
What else? What other one?
I do like every night where Jay is about to munch into his friend Jerry, that's so sweet, right up near the camera.
Yeah.
Very effective.
Yeah.
I think reaction though. Whoa.
Getting a little too close.
Yeah.
Yeah. I always love when the dad is Vikram, our director, doing his little cameo, is shouting from off screen. He's like, oh, have you seen the iPad? Oh, I found it. It's in the bathroom. And you know, the mom's just like, he's gonna be the second death of me. I'm just like, oh, I love the idea of there being a second death. That's wonderful.
And Dave, you're getting some applause in the chat for your scream when you get bit. Oh. Wanna give us any insight into that moment, Dave?
I don't know. That was another good Vikram direction tonight. You know, just balls to the wall. And so I just went, that was my biggest scream in that. So it was just, great direction.
I've got to say, there are two moments that I love every time. One I've mentioned before, sorry guys, love y'all, but that cat, every time that cat get the right, always gets me. I love it. And then the other part is when Jay and Dave have their moment where Jay starts laughing and it just like escalates. Absolutely fantastic. Just really, really fun. Really fun.
You know, that cat is a great sound effect. Tell us about the sound effects, Vikram. I mean, especially over Zoom.
Yeah.
You know, you've been really successful. There's both vocal and sound effects at the same time, which, you know, is rare on Zoom. So how'd you achieve all that?
Well, every time I've done something in theater, to the dismay of the people running tech for my shows, I have lots of sound effects. I love like using like, you know, putting lots of music and stuff like that. And basically doing whatever I can with like lighting and sound to make the audience feel like they're really there with the characters, with even all the little details. So with Yasha's script, there was like a lot of things going on, a lot of like things that were making sounds throughout the play, which I wanted the audience to feel. I didn't want them to be cheated out of any of those moments that Yasha wanted to communicate. So, and I wanted to show it in a way that like didn't look cheesy. I wanted to show it in a way that did it justice. So sometimes where maybe the effects might've been hard to pull off, we said, okay, let's get a great sound effect and show the character reacting and use that sound effect to kind of like illustrate the world that's going on, the cat jumping and stuff like that. Even just like the knocking on the doors at the right times. I love the song at the end. I always love a good ending song. That was my favorite sound effect. It was great. My favorite parts of the script was just getting so many opportunities to dress it up with sound effects and stuff like that. A lot of fun.
Well, you did a great job. Okay. All right. I guess congratulations, everybody. You know, what a beautiful, beautiful run. And thanks to everyone in the audience. And again, paypal.me/theater68. or Venmo at Theater 68. Keep the blood pumping. And there's close this week. This is closing week for the LA One Act Fest. So tomorrow night, same time, 7 p.m. Pacific, Codependent Relationships Are Blank, written by Val Gehli, directed by Nicholas Adams, and starring Nicholas Portal and Amanda Cassarella.
Oh, it's gonna be a great show
out this week. So so come back and support Theater 68 and expand your mind. All right, thanks everybody.
Hey, thank you, Annie.
Thank you, everyone. Amazing show, guys.
Congrats, Yasha. Congrats to the cast.
Congrats, guys.
Till next time, guys.
Great show.